front?
Get them while you can, Claire. Get them while you can. They're going to be going up in value. How do I know? Well, recently I went through the new line of Star Wars toys that Kenner has put out for the 20th anniversary of Star Wars trilogy. And who better to take me through that than the man who wrote the book on Star Wars collectibles right here, Steve Sansweet. Steve's the one with the sweater, by the way. We went out to the toy fair, and here's what we found.
All right, here we are at the 1997 International Toy Fair, and inside this room, Hasbro has unveiled a whole new line of Star Wars toys. Now, who better than to give us a tour of this place than the director of specialty marketing for Lucasfilms and a darn good super collector himself, Steve Sansweet. Steve, good to see you.
Hi, John. Good to be here again.
How are you? Good?
Great.
Good.
I love all this stuff.
I do, too. We have a lot to look at, so let's start with these 12-inch action figures. What do we have here, Steve?
Well, Kenner originally produced 12-inch action figures back in 1978 and 79, and because they were sort of scarce, these things have really gone up in value. The original Boba Fett, for example, is now selling for about $300 mint in the box. This year, you can buy one for $20 to $30, and you can play with it, take it out of the box. And for the first time, there's some new figures that were never done before, like Admiral Akbar and the TIE fighter pilot.
You know, it's going to be interesting to see what happens to some of the original pieces, because as you mentioned, about $300 to $400 for the Boba Fett. And now it's affordable, so we'll see what happens to the price on that
right.
original.
It's going to be a very interesting year to see what happens to collector's prices.
Okay, now over here we have some of the transport vehicles.
Yeah, these are really cool. This is Luke's T-16 Skyhopper. He mentions about bullseyeing Womp Rats and Tatooine, and he also actually plays with a model of this at the beginning of Star Wars. Brand new vehicle. Over here, and this is going to be another interesting thing to watch, is the A-Wing Fighter. It came out late in the line. These things now, mint in the box, are going for $500 to $600. $400 out of the box. This is going to be a new $25 to $30 toy. Has a great paint job on it. I think the original one will probably go down in value.
Now, one of my favorites is this over here. Now, tell me about this. This thing is great,
yeah,
Steve.
This is a re-sculpted AT-AT, and it has sound and light for the first time.
Cool. That thing is very cool. Now, over here, we actually have some of the creature. This is kind of like a creature festival.
Yeah, this is a brand new creature that George added to the Star Wars Special Edition. This is a Ronto, a beast of burden in Mos Eisley. And in the movie, it bucks a Jawa off its back. When it gets spooked, this toy will have the same ability to do that. The Dewback is also created by Digital Effects. The original one didn't move in the movie. George was very frustrated. They redesigned it. It moves. And now, the original Dewback from Kenner way back when is this bright green color. It really hasn't moved in price much, still around $35 to $40. I think people are going to want the retro one once they get this. That may go up in price.
It's interesting. So we think that maybe the original one will finally go up in price because of the new one.
Yeah, it's very possible. So some things may go up, some things may go down.
This is amazing the way they've got everything displayed here. Of course, they've got the trilogy, and it's all set up so nicely.
Mos Eisley, the speeder bike scene, just super.
Now, Steve, over here we have some of the new action figures, and I know there's a whole new line that they're introducing, a whole bunch of new ones.
Yeah, can you believe 71 new action figures this year, and for the first time, some figures that people have asked for years, the Grand Moff Tarkin, and especially the enslaved Princess Leia. She is going to fly off the shelves.
71 new figures.
That's right. There are going to be 100 figures by the time the year ends.
It's very exciting. Steve, I want to thank you so much for coming in and showing us this.
John, it's been my pleasure. You can tell Star Wars is my life.
Obviously, the Force is still with you.
It is.
Thank you, Steve.
You want to talk about Star Wars collectibles? Nobody knows more about that stuff than Steve Sansweet. The only question everybody here in the apartment wants to know, what about the ties? What's going to happen to the ties? Stick around. More appraisals coming your way when Personal FX returns.